Hi, my name's Steve. Welcome aboard my narrowboat home, Moorland Rose. Please join me as I take a slow boat through Britain. Last time, I left you as I moored up to visit a supermarket and pick up some supplies. We carry on from just outside of Rugby. I moved across the canal to the water point and filled up. You know me, I never miss a chance. This lovely warm weather is great for a leisurely cruise. Plenty of boats on the move again. I'm not sure why it's called Double Bridge, as there's only one bridge here. First of today's locks, and there's a lockie on duty. Looks like he's getting the towpath side lock ready for us. The locks here were duplicated when the canal was improved to speed up the passage of the working boats. It is always pleasant to have a chat with the locky. With the boat coming out of the offside lock, I'll head for that one. In the days of the working boats, when both of these locks would be in almost constant use, this paddle gear would be used to transfer water between the two locks, thus saving some water. Now, they are no longer used. This bridge is named for the borstal that lay over the hedge to our right. Borstals were the forerunner of the Young Offenders institutions of today. It is now HMP Onley, a Category C men's prison. With all the Armco, there are plenty of places to moor along the North Oxford Canal. Didn't see him until the last minute. Another bridge named for the pub which once stood close by. The spire of Braunston Church on the horizon shows we are getting close to the village that was considered by a lot of the old boat families as home. In fact, many of the families married in the church, and the graveyard contains the graves of a number of boat people. This is going to be tight. Warning from the last boater meant I was expecting this boat after the bridge. Braunston is always popular and often takes some threading through. I'll let these boats sort themselves out first. I have ordered an anchor from Tradline Ropes and Fenders and arranged to pick it up from their shop in Braunston Marina. They said to pull straight in, so here goes. The fact I'm buying an anchor may give you a clue as to which way I'm heading. Anchor loaded, I need to reverse back out. I am keeping a good lookout for any boats coming along the main line. Went well. lockies are working well, to have each lock ready for me. I offered to finish this lock while the lockie went back to check for more boats. Another of those iconic canalside pubs, but I need to carry on with the flight. Note, there are no gate paddles on these top gates, so I need to open the ground paddle on the opposite side, else I will be here all day. I normally just work one side of these broad locks. Another lockie, they really cut down on my workload. We had a bit of banter with this workforce, taking a break from tidying up the towpath, leaving the lady to work the lock. The last of the flight, I might just tie up for the night and take a walk back down to the Admiral Nelson.
I don't mind doing them on my own, but it's really a lot of help. I'd get you guys to help. Cheers, man.
Now that I am clear of the lock and there's plenty of room, I'll moor up and go get that well-deserved pint. Thanks for joining me. Come along next time when I disappear into the bowels of the earth. Until then, stay safe. See you soon.